Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm going to explain in this tutorial how to work with a BME280 a sensor which measures temperature, pressure and humidity, and how to connect the sensor to the Raspberry Pi. In my case, I'm connected and using with a Raspberry Pi number 5, and also do some tests with a Python library. To start with, let's take a look to the sensor. The sensor is this what you see here, very small sensor. It was designed initially for a smartphone, and later on it became general purpose. Is well known use on the industry. It support I2C and SPI interfaces. You had these specifications of operational ranges and resolution. You have here the address in memory where you write the signals 0, 76 and 77. And well, yeah, again, very conventional and use sensor on the industry. I use as well a library. There is some available free use on GitHub. You can find a lot of informations in internet. Many people working with this device, no? You need to do some changes in your Raspberry device. It will depend a little bit how which model you had, but essentially you can do everything with Raspi config. So let's move. Let me connect to. I'm connected here to the Raspberry with SSH. You can essentially go to the configuration, go to the interface, activate SPI. You didn't do it before, and activate I2C. So once it's done, you can do this as well in the graphical interface. I had also a session here in the graphical interface. You can do this as well. In the configuration, yeah, here as I did it before, well, is both of them are activated. Okay, I also install on my Raspberry in the graphical interface Visual Code, VS Code. I used to work with this IDE. You can use others, but it's quite well designed for Python development, so well, it's up to you what to use. I'm using this one, and as you can see, it's a package that you can simply activate on your Raspberry Pi. Did you go here? No, sorry, here is not. Is preferences, recommend the software. Exactly, you go just here to programming, at least in this Raspberry Pi OS version. You have this available directly on the recommended software. You just need to activate it. Okay, so we just install the library. It's pretty simple. Python or pip install this. Well, execute this command in an interface. I already did, and the library comes with some examples that you can use. Okay, what I use for that? I will post this presentation and output that I use for the development. I use well, just a solder with something, some cables, and here you have the I'm soldering the pins to the connectors, to the cavities of the sensors. You have the voltage, ground, SCL and SDA. Try to find a pinout picture of your Raspberry Pi. This is this belongs to a P5 Raspberry. There is some changes depending on the hardware that you are using, and here you see how I connected the BME280 to the Raspberry Pi. So the pin, the +3 volts to the pin number 17, ground to pin number 9, STL to pin number 5, there is also the GPIO3 signal, and also the SDA to the pin number 3. Here you see a picture of how it looks like. You just use the cables with the female to plug it on the male pin, and well, here just another a focused image of the same. No? And now let's go to the code. It's again I took just some examples of the available on the with the library. You just can check just here. It's pretty simple, all values just catching the temperature. This temperature is not compensated, that's why here I put another example that we are deducting the temperature of the CPU, and then sorry, Python compensated. Oops, yeah, it's PIPI. Yeah, and as you see here, this is the raw measure, and this is a compensated measure that is considering the temperature of the CPU and the changes. There is an error if you take the raw measure. And that's all, pretty simple. Again, there is plenty of examples available in internet. It's very simple. With this you can essentially measure with high precision temperature, pressure and humidity, and you can set up in a minute, a couple of hours, a weather station in a home. That's all. Thank you very much for watching me. And if you like the content, give me a like, and see you soon. Thank you.